She has gone from American Idol to faking it and now living boldly in the bold type. Welcome, Katie Stevens. Katie, first of all, the hair.
Katie. Girl.
Thank you.
Is this new?
It's new as of like a few days ago.
No, I always wonder.
It looks fresh.
Yeah, it's Thank so you. Fresh. Do you have to check with them before you get a haircut?
I didn't.
Uh-oh.
But my thought process is that if they want my hair to be long, they can
make it
put
long.
Extensions in my hair.
That would be my thought process also.
Yeah.
Until you get called into
That's the fun of being a girl. If we want long hair,
right.
We can have it.
No,
men too.
It's so.
Thank you.
You know, I only bring this up because I was so impressed by how multi-talented you are. You were on American Idol in 2010. You finished 8th in season 9. Mm. The judges were like, "This is the most talented girl I've ever seen." It's so impressive that not only can you sing the way you sing, but you can also act. So I just had to bring that up.
Thank you. Yeah. I appreciate that. Last night I was talking about American Idol, and it's so crazy. It will be 10 years that I auditioned this year.
What was the experience like?
It was incredible.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was great. I mean, I was 17, so it was all like such a whirlwind coming out of high school and going to do that. And then here we are.
Well, yeah, for sure. And you know, now, I mean, like, 10 years have passed, you're engaged.
Yes.
You just had your bridal shower.
I did.
Congratulations. How was
Thank
that?
Thank you. It was great. My friends threw it for me and they went above
fun.
And yeah. Oh. They went above and beyond and, you know, got me like a cake and bottomless mimosa.
Did you play baby games? I don't like those baby games.
No baby games for me. I'm very far from babies. I'm like, let me get married first.
Right, right. And we're going to talk about eggs in a second, so hold tight.
Whoa.
But you know what, have you ever, I have to ask you this. Tell me if you experience this. When you get engaged, do some of your friends start acting a little weird? Has anybody started acting a little weird?
No, all of my friends have been actually really lovely.
Aww, maybe just your friends.
That's adorable.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably.
No,
I've
but
never
I,
heard of that
I get
even,
it.
Even other people
Whatever.
Like, did, no, did you have not have any?
I think what does happen, but happens more when you have a child, is friends that aren't married with kids. It's just lives go
That's
a little
true.
Bit
yeah.
of a different
right.
path. And
I think
you
it
can't
was
go
more
out
of like
much,
before or... I got engaged, people asking, when are you getting engaged?
Oh, right.
And then you get engaged. When are you getting married? And
yeah.
then you get married. And people are like, when are you having kids? And you're like, ah.
Enough with the question.
Well, yeah. And then on top of it, your storyline is kind of about you freezing your eggs,
yes.
right? So you're getting it on both ends,
on
really.
On both ends. Well, I'm actually really happy that we do the storyline, because I think that society puts so much pressure on women to kind of like know what your plan's going to be, know when you want to get married, do all these things. And this storyline has taught me above all else that like women have options and just ask the questions to get the right answers, and so that you have more knowledge about what those options are. And if you don't want to have kids, you have the option to freeze your eggs and to wait. Mm-hmm. And I think that more women need to know that they have the right to ask those questions and to do whatever feels right for them.
I agree, and I want to make sure we get to the clip. So here is a clip from The Bold Type.
Good times. We should all go back to work.
Well, maybe we are working. I mean, isn't that the cool thing about being a writer? You could argue that every life moment is material.
No, not every life moment.
It's debatable.
Agree to disagree.
You agreeing to disagree with me is material.
That doesn't make sense.
Pitch. You two should write about your egg freezing process together.
Cool.
No.
Think about it. Two brilliant writers who are a couple going through this monumental change together. You could really dig in, explore the hopes around it, the fears.
Well, I hope that this isn't happening.
Right. And you know, and it begs the question, in your real life, how much are you willing to share as you continue to get more notoriety?
I mean, I think that I like to have the happy balance of allowing my fans and my followers to feel like they know me, but I do kind of like to maintain some form of anonymity so that I can go through my life and feel like I could make my own decisions without feeling like I have people. People are always going to have an opinion, let's be real, but just, you know, I like to kind of keep that barrier there so that I can still have some sense of normalcy in my own life.
I'm so glad you came in.
Thank you
so much. The Bold Type airs Tuesday nights at 8 p.m. on Freeform, and I love the pink shadow so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kate.
Thank you.